क्यों ऑडिबल बेटा, आवाज आ रही है सबको? लेट मी नो इन द कमेंट बॉक्स, एम आई ऑडिबल? यस, ओके ओके बेटा, नाउ लेट अदर स्टूडेंट्स ज्वाइन, लेट्स वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स के वो ज्वाइन कर लें, उसके बाद हम दोबारा सेशन को स्टार्ट करते हैं। मानो योर मेंबर्स आर रेडी, ऑल आर प्रेजेंट और नॉट? नो सर, दे आर नॉट प्रेजेंट। ओके, लेट्स वेट फॉर देम। आपने पीपीटी मुझे सेंड कर दिया था? टॉपिक ग्रुप 11 एंग्लो नॉर्मन पीरियड। ओके बेटा, ओके, नाउ हुज रेडी विद देयर प्रेजेंटेशन? चंद्र कुमार, इज योर ग्रुप रेडी बेटा? इफ इट इज रेडी देन रेज योर हैंड। ओके, अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ। बेटा अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ चंदर एंड स्टार्ट।
यस सर।
यस, नाउ स्टार्ट।
आवाज आ रही?
यस, यू आर ऑडिबल।
स्टार्ट द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह हु इज मोस्ट मर्सीफुल एंड ग्रेशियस, रेस्पेक्टेबल टीचर एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट क्लास फेलोज, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, नमस्ते एवरी वन। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू फाइन। टूडे वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट इन एंग्लो सेक्शन थ्योरी। एंग्लो सेक्शन टर्म यूज टू हिस्टोरिकली टू डिस्क्राइब एनी मेंबर्स ऑफ जर्मनिक पीपुल्स हु फ्रॉम द 5th सेंचुरी टू द टाइम ऑफ नॉर्मन कॉन्क्वेस्ट 1066 एडी इनहेबिटेड रूल्ड territories that are today part of England and Wales. Now, according to Senate Bill, the venerable Anglo-Saxon were descended from 3 Germanic peoples: Angles, Saxons, and Jutes. By Bill's account, those people are originally migrated from northern Germany to the island of Britain. In the 5th century, at the invitation of a Vortigern, a ruler of Britain, he helped depend upon this kingdom against invasion by Picts and Scouti. He is originally migrated from Germanic area of mainland. The earliest phase of English literature was started by Anglo-Saxon literature. Angles and Saxons was the ancestor of English race. English was the common name and language of these tribes. Before they occupied Britain, they lived along the coast of Sweden and Denmark, and the land which they occupied was called England. These tribes were fearless, adventurous, and brave. And during the later years of the Roman occupation of Britain, they keep British coast and tire like other nations. They sung at that were also God. I have done the introduction of Anglo-Saxon period.
Okay, that means your part is done.
Yes. Next one is Mr. Ali Muhammad. Give the presentation on literary work in Anglo-Saxon period.
Okay. Ali Muhammad, unmute yourself.
Assalamualaikum.
Welcome.
This is my topic, literary work in Anglo-Saxon period. Anglo-Saxon literature or old English literature written in Anglo-Saxon during the 600 years. Anglo-Saxon period of Britain from the mid 5th century to the Norman conquest of 1066. These works include genres such as epic poetry, hagiography, sermons, Bible translations, legal works, chronicles, idols, and others. In all, there are about 400 surviving manuscripts from the period, a significant corpus of both popular interest and specialist research. Some of the most important works from this period include the poem Beowulf, which has achieved national epic status in Britain. The Anglo-Saxon Chronicle is a collection of early English history. The poem Condamund Syme from the 7th century is one of the oldest surviving written text in English. Anglo-Saxon literature has gone through different periods of research. In the 19th and early 20th century, the focus was on the Germanic roots of English. Later, the literary merits were examined, and today the interest is with paleography. Questions and their physical manuscripts themselves, such as dating place of Aryan authorship and looking at the connection between Anglo-Saxon culture and the rest of Europe in the Middle Age. King Alfred the Great, 849 to 899, wanting to restore English culture, lamented the poor state of Latin education. King Alfred noted that while very few could read Latin, many could read Old English. He thus proposed that students be educated in Old English, and those who excelled would go on to learn Latin. In this way, many of the texts that have survived are typical teaching and student-oriented texts. Not all of the text can be fairly called literature, such as list of names or absolute pen trails. However, those that can present a feasible body of work listed here in descending order of quality, Saxmans and Saints, lives the most numerous biblical translation translated Latin works of the early church fathers, Anglo-Saxon chronicles and narrative history work, Law's Wills and other legal works. Practical works on grammar, medicine, geography, lastly, but no least important, poetry. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Who's the third member? Mithu? Okay. Yes, beta. Unmute yourself.
Hello, sir. Assalamualaikum.
You are the third member.
Yes, I am third member.
Why you do not make your PPT?
Sorry, sir. I have no laptop and I live in Tharpata. So
what about you?
I have no
members. They also do not have laptop. Okay, beta. Go ahead. Give your presentation.
No, sir.
Give your presentation. Go ahead.
Yes. The greatest of Almighty Allah. I hope all of you fine. My name is Mithumal. Today I am going to discuss about characteristic of Anglo-Saxon. Anglo-Saxon tribes were really brave, warrior, and so much powerful. They always and every time used to be ready to save their name, power, area, and fame. Absolutely, Anglo-Saxon had taken so much strong control on England with a lot of hardship and sacrifice. They never do something abnormal that their area can be in a danger. They physically were too strong, tall, and thick muscle. They never used to leave their enemy. They always used to kill them because they used to know that leaving our enemy means can be used cause of their destruction and other. They used to respect their women and children. They were warrior, powerful for their enemies, but for women and children they really loved. They were living in wood houses, features of their community. They were not living scatterly, but living in the form of unity. They had always unity in each other. The king of their side will be selected by the wise men of their tribe or community. They also used to celebrate a lot of celebration on a different occasion, like a winning battle, getting a marriage, etc. They used to live harsh environment like they faced flood, earthquake, and other several diseases. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay. Is there anyone left in your group, beta? Yes, Chandar. Bas aap teen hi the. Okay. See, Vital, Chandra Kumar, I don't know, why you guys did not make your PPT. So it was quite bad impression on your whole presentation that you did not have any PPT and we were unable to see that what actually you were talking about. And the first thing was, Chandra, you need to work on your pronunciation as you do not know how to pronounce the word Saxon. And I don't know, you were saying that section, I don't remember exactly, but you must listen this recording as well, and when you will listen this recording then you will come to know that what kind of mistakes you have made in your presentation. And apart from that, Chandar, you need to ensure that when you are giving presentation, so it's a kind of formal presentation, so that's why there must not be background noises. You must choose a place, or you must at least aap jab classein dusri le rahi hain to le rahe hain to aap apne ghar mein baith kar us noisy environment mein bhi le sakte hain, but when you are giving your presentation at least and on that day during that specific time you need to arrange a place where there's no background noise, jahan par background noise nahi hona chahiye, because due to your background noise I was being distracted. And the third point is that there was no PPT. And Ali Murad, you do not know how to pronounce the word literary. And your introduction was also missing, and Sam, there was no PPT, but overall the content was quite good. And it seems sometimes at some points Ali Mohammed, at some points I just felt mujhe ye thoda mehsoos hua ke something is written on the piece of paper in front of you and you are just keep on reading. You were just kept on reading that piece of paper. So ye ek do jagah pe mujhe ye thoda feel hua, baki mujhe ye pata nahi hai. चूंकि मैं वहां पर प्रेजेंट नहीं हूँ. देन द लास्ट प्रेजेंटर केम द मिट्टू एंड योर इंट्रोडक्शन वाज क्वाइट गुड एंड यू आर गिविंग योर प्रेजेंटेशन वेरी कॉमली एंड सेम इशू नो पीपीटी, सो दैट्स व्हाई ओवरऑल इट वाज अ गुड प्रेजेंटेशन. सो विश यू अ वेरी बेस्ट ऑफ लक बेटा. एंड आई होप कि जब आप नेक्स्ट टाइम प्रेजेंटेशन दें तो मेक श्योर के आपके पास एटलीस्ट एक पीपीटी बनी होनी चाहिए. सी बेटा, इन ऑर्डर टू मेक पीपीटी इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट यू मस्ट हैव अ लैपटॉप. आप लोग मोबाइल में इतने एंगेज्ड हैं तो यू मस्ट नो दैट दीज ऑल एप्लीकेशंस आर अवेलेबल एट प्ले स्टोर एज वेल. यू कैन डाउनलोड द एप्लीकेशन फ्रॉम प्ले स्टोर एंड देन यू कैन मेक अ पीपीटी. आप उसको अपने मोबाइल फोन के थ्रू भी बना सकते हैं, बिकॉज आई माई सेल्फ समटाइम्स मेड अ पीपीटी बाई यूजिंग माई मोबाइल. सो वाई यू गाइज कांट. सो सी बेटा, मेक श्योर के जब आप नेक्स्ट मरतबा दूसरी बारी जब आप प्रेजेंटेशन दें तो इन चीज़ों का थोड़ा ख्याल रखें. The reason I am telling you these all things is not that I am going to deduct your marks. मैं आपके कोई marks वगैरह नहीं इसमें detect कर रहा हूँ, but for the sake of your own understanding that next time अगर नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर में आपको ये सेम इस तरह की कोई अपॉर्चुनिटी हो, आप कोई और टीचर हो एंड आप उसको प्रेजेंटेशन दे रहे हैं, तो एवरी टीचर हैज इट्स ओन मेंटेलिटी. तो अब हर किसी की अपनी मेंटेलिटी है. सो यू सी सम पीपल सम टीचर्स डू नॉट कंप्रोमाइज इन सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो यू नीड टू बी वेरी मच केयरफुल बिकॉज ओवरऑल यू आर अ स्टूडेंट एंड यू आर वेरी मच कॉन्शियस अबाउट योर मार्क्स एज वेल. एंड इफ यू विल नॉट बी वेरी मच केयरफुल देन ऑब्वियसली यू विल लूज योर प्रेशियस मार्क्स. तो आई होप कि ये फीडबैक आपको काम आएगा इन फ्यूचर. नाउ महनूर, यस चंद्र, यू वांट टू से समथिंग, अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. यस
बेटा,
डू यू वांट टू से समथिंग बेटा, आर शुड आई म्यूट यू? ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू म्यूट यू. यस महनूर, रेज योर हैंड बेटा. नाउ turn of your group. Okay, let me unmute you.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes beta, you are audible.
Should I start?
Beta, did you send me PPT? And your topic was... Yes, sir. Wait. Give me a moment.
Group 11.
Okay beta, give me a moment please.
Sure, sir.
Here it is, introduction. The group 11 and your topic was Middle English?
Yes, sir.
Middle English. I have two PPTs with Middle English, 13, 15, 50 to 1500. Is that one?
Yes, sir.
Let me open it.
The presentation that Aman sent.
Yeah, this is Alfia Ariba. This is someone else. Okay. Let me open second one. And it belongs to Fiza Hafiz, Ganesh Fatima. But I don't find your presentation.
Aman sent the presentation in the group.
Yesterday, Aman. Do you have the presentation right now? Can you share it?
Yes, sir. Mariam has it.
Okay. Main aapko admin kar raha hun. So when you will become admin, then you can share screen from your side as well.
I think Mariam can share it because I don't know how to share this.
Okay. Let me open my WhatsApp again and to download your PPT because I have not downloaded that one. Just give me a moment. Sent by Aman. Focusful speech, Middle English. That is presentation sent by group 11, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, beta, I found it. Now let me open it. It is in PDF form, I guess.
Yes.
Gul Muhammad Mahnoor Mazari and Gul Bibi and Mariam Islam. Okay, beta, wait.
Yes.
Found it. Now let me share it for you. Here it is. Go ahead.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum and a very good afternoon, respected teacher and my fellow classmates. I am Manur Mazari and I'm here today along with my group mates to talk to you about Anglo-Norman period, followed by Mariam Gul, Mariam Islam and Gul Bibi. I'd like to start with the introduction of Anglo-Norman period, also called Middle English period. This period lasted from about 1066 AD to 1558 AD. The Norman language was introduced to England during the rule of William the Conqueror. The Normans' king, William the Conqueror, defeated Anglo-Saxon King Harold at the Battle of Hastings and conquered England. Norman conquest brought enormous changes in England, English literature and linguistics. Explaining it furthermore, my groupmate Mariam Gul will take the lead. Thank you for your time and attention. Maryam.
Maryam, unmute yourself.
Assalamu alaikum, my respected teacher and fellow classmates. I am Maryam Gul. My presentation topic is Anglo-Norman period, and I'm going to discuss about the historical background of Anglo-Norman period. Anglo-Norman period started in 1066 AD to 558 AD. Some says it ended in 1558 AD and some says in 1350. So moving on, it is divided into three parts: before Chaucer, Age of Revival. William the Conqueror was the Duke of Normandy. Actually, Normandy is located in France. He defeated the King of England that was ruling at that time. His name was Harold. He was defeated by William the Conqueror. And the battle is called Battle of Hastings, which happened in 1066. And the William won the battle, and he started what we know today, today as the Anglo-Norman period. The English literature after this divided into two: Anglo-Saxons before 1066 AD and Anglo-Norman after 1066 AD. After the Battle of Hastings, the French became the ruler of England. Then Anglo-French became the official language because all the acrostic people were speaking French, and middle class and the lower middle class were talking in Old English. So both of these languages combined form what we know today as Middle English. Even if you ever go to see the root of any word, you will find that most of the words of English language either having root of Latin or French. Latin, because Romans had a very big influence during Old English period and Anglo-Saxon period. After French invasion, French words were added. Most of the words English has today are either Latin or French in origin. Example, I will give you the example. Do you guys know how many French words are there in English? There are around 7,000 French words in English language at present time. Car, chair, city, country, different, mention, and so on. This was the period when schools and colleges were set up all across the England. How so? Let me tell you. There was war went between eastern part of the world and the European countries. That war was known as Crusades. Crusade actually was a religious war. The authority of Christianity were in the hands of popes. So the pope said all the Christians, they have to go and convert Eastern countries into Christianity. And when these people went, so they started reading their texts. Lots of Greek and Roman texts were taken by these Europeans. These texts were read by the peoples of England. When Crusade people went there, then came back with the text, people started reading it. Earlier, what happened was that clergymen were the only people who were educating people. Then people had access to other texts. They started learning themselves. So educations move outside the church, and that is how schools and universities were started building up. Now, there were two major institutions were set up, Cambridge and Oxford. Two main colleges were set up during this period. Though it has no official official founding date, but they were set up somewhere in 12th century. London became the main center of education. That is the reason you will find almost all great writers of British history were there in London. Now my groupmate Maryam Salam will take the lead. Thank you.
Excellent. Shabash. Well done.
Thank you, sir.
The next one, please raise your hand, Beta. Maryam Islam. Okay. Yes, Beta Maryam Islam, you have to unmute yourself from your side. You have to unmute yourself from your side as well, Maryam Islam. Okay, okay.
Hello.
Yes, beta.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now. From which slide you will start, beta?
Sir, I will be present from age of tonsil and age of revival.
Okay. This one, age of revival?
And age of tonsil.
Okay, okay. Got it.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Maryam Islam and today my presentation is about that age of tonsil and age of revival. Firstly, I will represent the age of tonsil. In this era, 100 years of wars was happening between England and France. In this Black Death occurred twice. Population of Europe was getting decreased and the peace was about to end. Because of Norman pushing taxes and lucratively on Europe continuously. And another part was Geoffrey Chaucer, who was great impact in English literature. He took part in 100 Years of Wars and he wrote a very famous book, was Canterbury Tales. Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. I can hear you. Go ahead. Yes, beta, go ahead.
And secondly, I will represent the age of revival. Age of revival. So firstly, I will tell you that why this age is called age of revival. It is the time when all literature are revival, when people start looking back and started reading the ancient lots of Roman and Greek texts, lots of Roman and Greek were circulating because of crashes and Roman literature was spread across the Europe. People start appreciating what fantastic work all writers have written because our literature started imitating and at least reading text. We know that as period of resonance. Resonance means rebirth, something which has died and again start come up is rebirth. So all the Greek and Roman elder culture, music, literature, everything were died. Because Roman civilization collapsed around 400 AD and after 1400 AD, they are around 1400 AD, started looking back. And these words, this reason why this is called resonance. Now I will tell you historical events in this era. First historical events what happened in this era was that War of Roses. In this age, War of Roses were happening between two parliament houses. One is House of New York and another one is House of Lancaster. And this war is for that who was the King of Roses. And now I will tell you the second historical event. The second historical event was that William Considine came printing press to Europe. In earlier, their era was wooden block printing press. And now the third event was that the third era was that Henry VIII, who married six wives and killed each one of them, not giving birth to male child. And he kept getting married. Now I will tell you the last important part of this era was that many colonies were discovered. Everyone think that there are only Europe, but after that they are realized that the world is so large.
Are you done, Peter?
Sorry, sir. What did you tell? What did you say?
I just said that, are you done or still your presentation is remaining?
Yes, sir. I have done.
Okay, beta, okay.
Sir, now my group member, Gul Baby, will present.
Okay, still there is one member remaining, right? So, yes, beta, Gul Baby, you have to raise your hand because we are running out of time. Gul Baby, okay. Unmute yourself. Yes, beta, unmute yourself, Gul Baby.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, beta. Now I can hear you. You are audible. Which slide, beta?
Jeffrey Chaucer.
This one. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Hope you all are fine. My name is Kulbibi Muhammad Yas, and my topic is Jeffrey Chaucer. This man was such a big impact in the field of English literature that the entire age, when he write English, give the status the language of court. We know this particular age from 1343 to 1400 as the age of Chaucer. We say around because we exactly don't know when he was born. He worked under three kings. And kings called Geoffrey her because he has lost lots of experiences. He was a man who participated 100 years war, plus he went on so many exploration around Europe. And that is the reason he was able to meet so many people. He was able to look at their perspective. And finally, he was able to pull all those experiences together in one book, which is known, that is Canterbury Tale. But not as just Canterbury Tale he has written. There has been some fine work written by him. But Canterbury Tale is most significant work of Chaucer. This work is very unique. He read 120 tales, but he wrote just 24 because of his death. The tales are presented as a part of a storytelling contest by a group of pilgrims. 29 pilgrims they are. Were came London to Canterbury, visit the shrine of St. Thomas Becket at Canterbury Cathedral. The prize for this content is a free meal at the Thibault Inn of Southwark on their return. Canterbury is a collection of poetry, not prose. Okay, sir.
Okay, beta. Done.
This is all from my side.
Okay, beta. Okay. Done. Thank you so much. Now, beta, let me give you comments very quickly because this session is also going to be added. The first presenter was Mahnoor, and Mahnoor, your introduction was quite good. And the way you were giving your presentation, that was also very much impressive, and that was excellent. But the problem which I found in your presentation was too short. I don't know why, but you just gave a brief introduction about the topic and about your group members, and then you just handed over mic to your next presenter, which was Mariam. So that was a very good presentation, but if you could have included some more material in your presentation, then obviously you would have did a great job. Now let's move forward to the next presenter, and that was Mariam. And Mariam, seriously, this is one of the best presentation which I have listened through the online mode. Like, still I do remember the presentation of Leila, and she has presented in the physical class, but if I talk about the online mode, then this one is the best presentation which I just saw. And the introduction was excellent. The way of presenting was very much excellent. Your content, especially, I love the content which you mentioned in your presentation. And the more important thing was you gave so many examples in order to justify your argument, justify your point. You were quoting examples which made your presentation very impressive and very much attractive to listen. And apart from that, each and everything was being explained very vividly and clearly, that each and everything was very, very easy to be understood. That means each and everything was on fingertips and it was very easy to be understood. More importantly, overall presentation was excellent. Then Mariam Islam, I found some mistakes, and your presentation was also indeed good, but I found some issues in your presentation, like you were pronouncing some words very inaccurately. Suppose you said that historically, I don't know why, but it's historically or historical background, and the War of Roses happened. See, Vita, the war is the thing which cannot happen by itself. the thing which happens itself. It is not a war. War always is done, it is fought by the two parties. So it can never ever happen by itself. So grammatically, it is very, you know, very wrong. And you said that they are realized. So obviously they are realized. How would you say that they are realized? So this is the way you need to work a little bit on your pronunciation and the grammatical aspect of it as well. Then came the Gulbibi, you also did some mistakes that you were saying that Canterbury Tales. So I don't think so that is a Canterbury Tales, but the pronunciation of this word is Canterbury Tales. Okay, but a Canterbury Tales. And the word, it's a Tabarin. It's a Tabarin, it's kind of restaurant. And the second is the particular. We say that's particular, but I don't know why, but you were pronouncing this word very inaccurately, very wrong. So that's why I mentioned these words. So overall, this was the feedback on your presentations. And then I hope that you will work on your mistakes and the weak points, and in future you will work on them in order to improve yourself and make a better version of yourself, because you all are my students. And it's a great pleasure of being a teacher is that when your students progress very much, in a fast way and very speedy. If they do progress, speedy progress, then you see, we also become very happy to see you while progressing. So wish you a very best of luck. Now tell me if there is any group left with the presentations, please let me know. Possibly you have to raise your hand. Alfia. Okay, Alfia. Unmute yourself, beta.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. Sir, we are left, actually.
Okay, your group is remaining, right, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, beta, this session is going to be expired in 2 minutes. So I'm afraid that you are unable to complete the presentation in 2 minutes. So that's why I will take your presentation in next session. Is that okay?
Yes, sir. It is okay.
Okay, beta. Now still Gul Bibi's hand is raised. Mariam, Gul Mohammed. Yes, beta, you want to say something? Your hand is raised.
No, sir.
Okay. Then you have to lower your hand. Maria, you want to say something better? Unmute yourself.
Yes, Assalamualaikum, sir.
Waalaikum assalam, Maria, beta.
सर मैं कह रही थी कि हमारा ग्रुप थे सर एक लड़की प्रेजेंट नहीं है वो उसकी तबीयत ठीक नहीं है
तो डजंट मैटर इफ यू वांट टू गिव योर प्रेजेंटेशन देन यू शुड गिव
यस सर
ओके हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स आर देयर इन योर ग्रुप बेटा
सर थ्री मेंबर्स
एंड टू आर प्रेजेंट एंड वन इज एब्सेंट राइट
नो सर वी आर फोर्थ मेंबर्स वन एब्सेंट
ओके गॉट इट सो नेक्स्ट सेशन जैसे ही हम स्टार्ट करते हैं तो उसमें मैं अभी इसको बंद कर रहा हूँ दूसरा सेशन हम फौरी से स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं ओके बेटा ज्वाइन अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू एंड दिस मीटिंग एंड देन लेट्स मीट इन नेक्स्ट सेशन बाय
ओके